Starting in Android 15, apps will be edge-to-edge by default after they target SDK 35. We want to give you simpler defaults. So give your status, your gesture, and three-button navigation bar to be simple.
Generated previews are coming to Android 15. Now, using Glance, you can emit a remote view to be used in the picker preview instead of just a static resource.
And Glance 1.1 is now available and in release candidate, bringing a new unit test library, error UIs, and new components.
Android 15 removes the developer option for predictive back system animations. This means any app that has already adopted cross-task, cross-activity, and back-to-home animations will be visible to the user.
We're also happy to announce that Credential Manager is coming to wearOS 5. With this integration, you'll be able to sign in using your passkeys, passwords, or sign in with Google right from your watch. We've also made improvements to Android TV. First, a new video discovery API is coming to TV that simplifies the integration that powers one of the most used features on TV. Second, round app icons are now standard. And third, there are new modes to optimize for power consumption. We're excited to announce a new set of Compose APIs for building adaptive layouts with material guidance. We have three layouts that implement common adaptive scenarios.
We call this pen expansion. In Android 15, this feature is being added to activity embedding, and this support will also come to Material 3 Adaptive. And now, Android for cars.
Convincing your boss you need to expense a new car just so you can test your Android app. So, we're releasing a system image for Pixel tablets that runs Android Automotive.
Camera X is Jetpack library designed to make your life easier when integrating with camera sensors. The first beta release of Camera X 1.4 brings a whole host of new features, including Ultra HDR image capture and stabilization of both the camera preview and the recorded video.
You will now be able to show the preview on screen using a viewfinder composable. Next, let's talk about performance.
So Android 15 includes Angle as an optional layer running on top of OpenGL on top of Vulkan, which will help standardize the Android OpenGL implementation for improved compatibility and, in some cases, improved performance. In past releases, we made improvements in intents, so malicious apps couldn't exploit intents and intent filtering matches. So we're enabling the features under strict mode to help you test your app to make it compatible. To reduce unintended background activity launches, pending intent creators will now block them by default. We've also begun working on Kotlin multi-platform support for multiple Jetpack libraries, with stable versions of collections, view model, and data store are now available, and Room is available in alpha.
Let's take a look at our new canary, codenamed Koala. So first, take a look at this line right here, and notice what happens when I scroll it out of sight. It doesn't actually leave. It sticks to the top. This is called sticky lines. Next cool feature I want to show you is inline breakpoints. So this line here has multiple breakable locations because of the lambdas. And if I want to set a line breakpoint, in the past, we would show you a disambiguation pop-up. Now, I can just go and individually toggle breakpoints on the line. But now I want to show you what's coming next, which is Koala feature drop. It turns out that there are a lot of slow USB 2 cables out there. So let me show you what happens when I use the cable that I happen to know is slow. So look in the bottom right corner of the screen. So here we get a pop-up, and this is saying that this connection could be over 10 times faster if we used a better cable. All right, so we can see my phone. So check out this cool new feature we have in the running devices window. There's the quick settings pop-up. So I'm just gonna click on this, and I'm gonna say, give me dark theme. And just like that, my whole phone is in dark theme. Or maybe I want to look at translations. So quick settings, here we list all the languages in the app. So I can just go down and say, for example, Korean, so we can see the app updated. We can reset. If I just disconnect the device, it'll also reset these edits. But the next thing I want to show you is the layout inspector. So I can launch the layout inspector here, and I can still interact with my app here, but we also get these little bounds rectangles. This is showing where views are, including those that are behind in overdraw and even some off-screen views. And also, you can see these yellow highlights. This is the layout inspector highlighting Compose recompositions, because this app is partially written in Compose. So now I can, for example, turn on a deep component inspection. This is a selection cursor, so I can just navigate to the corresponding Compose code. I can go in and You can see the recomposition counts are showing up here. I can inspect properties. So for example, we can jump to the login buttons, on-click handler, and so on. The last thing I want to show is that we can pull down a snapshot of the app. What we're seeing on the left now in the whole editor pane is a static snapshot of the app. But it has all the layers and textures. And so we can now go into 3D mode, and we can see this is a quite complicated app. A new feature we have for Compose developers is UI check. And I can start it by clicking this button. This is basically lint for your layouts. And then it looks for problems. And so in this app, it's mostly accessibility issues. Notice that as I'm navigating through, we get these little yellow flashes or animations in the right side pane. This is showing which configurations are affected for each warning. Another really important factor for usability is startup time. And so the best thing you can do for yourself is to create a baseline profile. And we've recently made it a lot easier to create those. So what you do is you go into your app, and you invoke the module template. And there is now a baseline profile generator template. So you can see this baseline profile module. And what it also gives us is a new run configuration. So what you do is you create this module, you run this run configuration. This is going to launch your app on a device. It's going to capture what the startup paths taken were, pull them back to Studio, put them in this file. You then check this into version control. You build. This gets packaged with your app and deployed with your app. And now your app starts faster. But sometimes you need to actually optimize your code. And that starts with measuring. And for that, of course, you use the profiler. If you used the profiler before, this looks very different. So the new UI for the profiler is task-oriented instead of being organized by tool. So you pick the task you want to do. So let's say I want to look at the memory usage. So I'll say analyze memory usage and start profiling. Here it is. So if I, for example, want to know why segment pool is still here, I just find one of the instances, then I go to the references, and I work my way back through the pointers back to a garbage collection route. And last but not least, we're working on additional tools here. So one of the tools we're working on is integrating Leak Canary. So hopefully, if things go well, next I/O, I'll see you all here, and I'll demo Leak Canary. It wouldn't be Google I/O if I didn't talk about AI, right? So I can go in and create a file called .aiexclude. I'm going to place it at the root of the project. But you could place it anywhere. This is just like a gitignore file. In fact, it's the exact same syntax and grammar as a gitignore file. So if I, for example, put a wildcard like this, I'm saying exclude everything in my project. But sometimes it's nice to be able to tell the AI what you want. And so for that, we have a new feature we launched yesterday in Canary, and it's called custom transformations. So I'm going to select this, this currency class, and I'm going to right-click and say Gemini, transform selected code. And if I say add currency names, it's now guessing some names that seem reasonable and adds a new property. And it shows it as a diff, and I can say, yeah, good job, I'll take it. I can also refine this query. So if I say refine, I can add more steps. And I'm going to say add Japan and Korea. And so now it's continued adding to this transformation. Now I can go into the transformation history. And so if I don't like that last step, for example, I can go back to the previous one, and I can redo it. So everything I've shown you so far today is available in Canary. Now I want to show you a few things that we're working on for hopefully releasing soon, maybe some of it a little bit later. So here I have a string function, which is computing the optimal alignment between two strings. So let's go ahead and press Shift F6. And the first couple of options is what you usually get in Studio. But look at number 3 and 4. What's happening here is that Gemini suggests these two names. Gemini menu and say, rethink variable names. So what this is doing is it looks at the whole method body, figures out how the variables are used, and proposes potentially better names. Another feature we're working on, you want us to help you write unit tests. So I can invoke the generate menu in Studio and say test scenarios. Then I choose the methods that I want to create test scenarios for. And then it's going to suggest all the tests I should write to really cover this method. So let me show you what it just did. Look at this. We have a unit test. Last small demo is commit message assistance. I just click on the Gemini button here. It's going to look at the diffs and suggest the commit message. And yeah, update Norwegian strings. Looks reasonable. So I'm going to say /model 1.5. When I switched to the 1.5 model, I actually got these new icons here for attaching stuff. So I'll attach first the mockup I just showed you. And we're asking it to please write the Compose code to implement that screen in this code base. Importantly, using existing styles, themes, custom composables, and so on. So here's the new code. Here it is. And the best part, look at the code. It is actually using custom composables from my project. So this isn't pre-trained standard Compose. This is Compose the way it should be written in this JetSnack project. You know, I think these capabilities are opening all kinds of possibilities for us in Android Studio. We're working on a bunch of prototypes that I'm excited about.
Let's talk about a new feature that the Crashlytics team recently built to monitor new app releases. As you can see, we've got a really nice adoption curve showing the new release is showing up. You just saw it update in real time. That happens every 30 seconds or so. We've recently released a new feature we're calling Data Insights right here. So what we do is we analyze all the instances of the crash and we try and understand the commonalities and display them to you here.